G'day gamers, welcome to Noob by Design. Gonna be doing a video here today showing you guys how to easily defeat Marvel Avengers boss Monica Rapacini. Alright gamers, so this difficulty is set to hard difficulty, so you may take more or less damage depending on the difficulty setting you've chosen. The fight is broken down into three phases, with the first having four attacks to worry about. One you just saw there was the turret attack, where she ends up shooting her turret at you for a little bit. The second is that ground pound attack, that's kind of an area attack, and you can easily avoid that by dodging to the side. The third was that attack we just saw there, which was a two-hit combo, two hits in sequence there, and you can dodge it by dodging to the left or behind. If you dodge to the right, you'll probably take some damage. And the final hit is pretty much impossible to dodge. It's that large area jump ground pound that you just saw right here right now. And that one is basically you're just going to take the damage. So let's restart the fight here and show you guys how to pretty much not have to worry about any of those attacks in phase one at all. All we're going to do is keep on continuously shooting at Monica here at a bit of a distance. We're going to walk or let the distance close a little bit to avoid the majority of Monica's attacks. And essentially what it'll cause her to do is start charging towards you here. When the attack happens, you're going to go ahead and just dodge to the side, or if it's this gun turret one, just jump off the side, hit the X button so that you actually go back on, and what that'll do is cause Monica to stop shooting, and then you just kind of keep cycling through very quickly here. You'll see just by going through this, it'll hit the shielded. That's going to end phase one and cause four of these little flying drones here, to the security drones, to spawn, and all you'll have to do is go ahead and again shoot those at a bit of a distance here. Not too hard, just try to stay away from the middle because they'll throw a whole lot of bombs and gases in the middle there. That'll do you a decent amount of damage. Once we finish off here, it'll end up going ahead and kicking off phase two, which has some more moves, and it's going to be a bit of a pain. This is going to be the first move here, which is a charge, and it basically coats the floor in ice, which will potentially freeze you as well as do some damage to you. The next is that jump attack again, just avoiding it by jumping off the side like I'm doing right there. And the final attack is going to be basically shooting snowballs at you. Again, they do damage. When you jump back on off the side here, make sure that you don't jump in it like I did right there, because as soon as you step in it, you run the risk of freezing, and what that'll do is potentially lock you in place to take a whole lot of damage, and that's no good at all. Again, you can see anytime any of these three attacks that are coated in ice, we're just jumping off the side. It's not going to be super fast defeating her like this, but this way here, you really minimize your risk. Because the problem is as soon as you try to melee any of these attacks, she's got that frost around her, and it's going to basically be impossible. You're going to die super fast. You're going to see, I kind of got myself in a bad situation coming up here. Get myself frozen, and you'll see how fast this damage is. I was pretty much full health, and just by standing in the ice, I almost died. It literally took probably two-thirds of my health just doing that. So we're going to go ahead, again, just ranged attacks at a distance. Also, if you run out of health by using that last one that I did right there, there is also one on this platform. And this is a really good platform as well to use, because the only move that she can use against you is basically the snowball move. I've never seen her jump over there. I shouldn't say it's impossible to do, but I've just never seen it happen, and I've went through this fight a whole bunch of times. Again, as soon as any move happens, all we are doing, jumping off the platform or to the side of the platform until we end phase two, which just happened right there. And this is what you're going to want to use all your special abilities for. Try not to use any for these starter mobs here because they're not very difficult. The one you're going to need it for is the android, the adapted droid, or whatever you call those ones there. And you're going to want to use Veil of Shadows for that. Save all of your other stuff for phase three of the Monica fight, because it can be very, very challenging. Even if you are struggling with these guys, which I really shouldn't be, I don't know why I took so much damage on these guys, because they're not really that difficult, but as soon as this droid here pops, you're going to want to go ahead, use Veil of Shadows, and start using your heavy attacks. Hit the triangle button, cycle through them to try to do as much damage as is physically possible before here, and hoping that you can actually stun him and do a finishing move on him, because that'll be ideal what you want. And because Veil of Shadows didn't give us enough power to go ahead and kill this Adaptoid, we're going to go ahead and use Widow's Bite, shoot the Electrode, and then continually keep on damaging him until he is gone, just because that Adaptoid is brutal and probably actually the hardest part of this fight. Now that we've gone ahead and killed the Phase 2 separation there, we are on Phase 3, where we've switched from fire, or from ice powers to fire powers, and there will be a whole lot of fire grenades tossed at you. We're going to go ahead and do, again, ranged attacks and any anytime anything is coming at us, we're just going to continue jumping off the side to absolutely avoid everything. Once we get a chance to here, we're going to go ahead and use our power surge just to basically increase our damage, use our charge staff here and output as much damage as we can. We're going to do a bunch of short ranged or light melee attacks at the start here. Then we're going to go ahead and switch over to some heavy attacks once we start doing some dodging and getting a chance here. You see we've got an opening here. We've got him stun locked. So now let's go ahead and pound off the attacks here. Probably what I should have did is jump down here for my power surge because I'm running out of charge time here with it. And I should have really put as much heavy attacks into him as possible. I couldn't start with him there though just because he was she was actively swinging. So you want to make sure you're careful of that. Again, we've ended up charging up Widow's Bite again. So we'll go ahead and shoot it and that will go ahead and finish this fight. Probably the most challenging part about this fight is just kind of figuring out that you have to jump off the edge when any of the attacks are coming, and that Adaptoid, which is just brutal to go against. So just make sure you save your special abilities for it, and again, save your power surge at the end for when you're in phase 3 fighting Monarchy. Alright gamers, if you guys found this video useful at all, I sure would appreciate if you guys would go ahead and hit that like button. I'm also going to be pushing out a bunch more content on Marvel Avengers, so if you guys want to go ahead and hit that subscribe button, you'll be notified every time a new video comes out. Alright gamers, thanks for watching.